Hello for Wednesday, May 13th. This is the Dow. You can see we pointed this area out. We didn't have the line on, but yesterday in the video, as of course this is normal support because you had all these touches over here a few days back, beginning of May, and then over here about a week or so ago. So we figured this is going to be a bounce. Also, it was a lower Bollinger Band. So if it dropped through the 50 period, look at the lower Bollinger Band, this area, and that's just what it did. And as you can see, we had stochastics drop under 20 and come back over 20. We do have the MACD turning up here, but it has not crossed over as yet. It seemed a little weak. The market was obviously did not drop far. There's still dip buyers in there, but a lot of stocks didn't seem to be moving as much. We had some breakouts. We'll get to those in a minute. But they didn't. They pulled back. Didn't really hold a lot of force in them, so maybe the market has to pull back some more. We'll look at that. So right now, of course, this lower line, if that breaks, you could probably short it right there because it could pull down to this next level, 81.50-ish area, 81 even lower here, the 200 period. That is moving up. This is, again, the 60-minute chart. And on the SPX, also not much of a dip, a little bit below the 50 period on the 60-minute, and then back up again. Not much change in any of the other indicators such as the RSI and stochastics and so forth. So it stayed in this range. Obviously, if it breaks below this trend line, it would drop down probably to this. It has lower support here, which is just at or under this 200 period EMA on the 60-minute chart. So it's just fiddling around here. Maybe some big news will make a run, but I think it'd be better if it pulled back for a while or consolidated for a week or two if it's going to make another run at a new high. We'll see what goes on there. Now look, a lot of people are looking at the SPX to drop down to the 877, 875 area, and just because of this, we had this, remember, tried to get above it here, failed three times in a row, and then it broke out. So now this, because this was resistance a few times, now it should be pretty good support. Doesn't mean it's going to hold. A lot of people will be watching that and see if it does hold, then they're going to be buying in because they'll think, wow, now we can get back off the races. At least that's the thought. Now, shorts may be thinking something else. We'll see. So if it gets down there at 875, if you've got some longs, you may want to watch them as well because this bounces. Maybe there will be another burst. Now, we don't know how much strength there'll be. But if there is, maybe could at least run up to the, this is a daily chart, up to the 950 area. That is the 200-day EMA. Now, if this line breaks, look to this lower trend line, which may even come down to that 850, which is the 50-day EMA. But look for this lower trend line and see what happens at that. Okay, and on the Russell, Russell came down to its trend line, didn't get down to that 38% retrace. That is support around 480 to 42. But it came down to the trend line, bounced up there, and of course, it, as usual, its little stochastics moved up over 20 just as it bounced up. Okay, what's up next? Okay, we had some breaks. So we mentioned we had a couple things like the gapped up or a couple of those penny stocks that shot up really nicely and then just pulled back. So that tells us that maybe the at least for Tuesday, those speculative players were not ready to just keep their money in there. They wanted to get in, take the money, and get out. Now, for other things, like gold here, we got Barrick Gold. This did move out, and this had a double play. As you know, we like these. When it has a trend line here, broke out of and a horizontal, both at the same time. Not only gained about 4.3%, but still, it's pretty clean here. And now we've got a double area also of support when it comes back down. The volume did increase, so maybe we have another day or so of running on ABX. We'll see how that goes. And of course, along with gold, we've got our GDX Renko chart. Remember, this is 60 minutes, and this is loose. We don't have big stops in this at all because we just played. This is up, I don't know, 100. I don't know how many percent it's up so much this year. This is the big mover, as you know. We just keep on going long. When we get these indicators back over 100 or back up over minus 100 like here, and when we got the parabolic SAR under the pattern, when it goes above the pattern like it did here and we get a crossover, as the red lines indicate, then we short sell. So we're still in the long situation here, up since about 33.5. It's now 38.5, and we'll sell that and go short once we get a cross back over here. and parabolic czar reversal, and everyone has their own method, but this is one way that's just, it's a cash cow, really. It's just fantastic. It's worked for now 1 year. We've been working with this, a little bit over a year, I think. Anyway, okay, we got additions to the watch list, and this time we do have several shorts. It's interesting. The market isn't set up exactly as a short. Remember, it's been strong. These dips keep on getting bought. But when we see these stocks, if the market does happen to turn here, we've got some setups, okay? If it doesn't, maybe we've got still some longs as well. But these are ones that are kind of ready. They could drop. And so we've added them to the list because they're prime situations. If the market turns and if people decide, let's just take our profits now for a while, that doesn't mean we might not continue later in the market in this bear rally. But for instance, APA, if it breaks over here, now look, it got as low as 70, where is it low? 79.25, but we're saying it gets under 79 in this area here. I think it's a short. Now pay attention to what the market does because these could turn, but look, it's primed to break down. It ran up, it came down a couple days. It's increased volume on the day on Tuesday, so if it breaks below that 50-day, or that 200-day, it may drop down to the 50-day, or at least down to this trend line. So under 79, APA, a possible short there. MDVN, on the other hand, looks like a pretty good long. Increase in volume as it moved up, so if it can move over 2101, at a golden cross not long ago, so it looks pretty decent, and we're not at all overbought as far as RSI or stochastics or MACD, so this could move higher over 2101, and we want decent volume. Again, on the short side, MTB under about 48.40. Now, this is hard to call exactly. 48.44 was what the low was. But you can see we've got 48.70 was this that it broke, and then it's got 46.93, but it's an estimate. It's not exact, but it does put us back underneath the 50-day EMA, and it depends on volume. So if you're going to play this one short, if it turns out to be a short, then you have to use your own judgment. But it looks like about this line where we put it here could be a possibility for a continuation play, especially if the market pulls back for several days. Now, BIG is short under 24.30. This one also is not exact, and it got as low as, well, that's in fact what its low was at 24.30. So it breaks underneath its low on Tuesday because it's got 23.18. It wouldn't be a big drop to go down there, but it'd be a profitable one over a dollar. So that's worth the trade. Now, if the volume did pick up, of course, it could continue and come back down because remember, this 200-day was very good support in here. So if it broke the 50-day, it could drop down to the 200-day once again. Volume did pick up a little bit on Tuesday. That's BIG. CRM, another possibility is short. In this case, we're saying under 40. And if it breaks under 40, then it closed at 40.87, so it didn't move back up. Its low was 40.37. But I think under 40, then we've got a little bit. I'm sorry, not 40. What are we saying? So, yeah, under about 40. Here we've got 39.02. So a dollar from under 40, 39.02 would give us the 200-day. And if it dropped below there, it could come down to the trend line. So we've got a possible dollar profit if the short works out and if it doesn't drop a whole lot. Now, ALTI, in this case, this looks like a possible long. Look at this big volume on the gap up a couple days ago. Now, pull back, so it'd be better if this could consolidate for even if several days would be fine. Because it is trying to get above this 200-day. So then if it breaks above, now we're saying 151. This is 150 here. But if you widen this chart out, just go to our watch list page. You can widen the chart out. And you can see there was over here in the past that 151 was some resistance. So we'll give it that extra penny. If it moves above 151 on good volume, this is a possibility on the long side. Also, just quickly, remember we've got some of these low-volume stocks. I don't think we have time to show them actually, but this is a possibility, CHTP, but very low volume. Not many can play that one. This one's tiny, tiny, tiny. I wish it wasn't. It's a nice-looking chart. Anyway, it's too low volume. So that's what we got for this middle of the week Wednesday. Thanks a lot for coming by the site. I hope you have a good day trading, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.